Hello everyone, welcome back to old school. In this series we are learning about the basics of computer system. In the first lecture we have learned about the term computer, hardware and software, and in this second lecture we are going to see the basic parts of computer and learn about how these devices are connected with each other. So without wasting any time, let's start. Monitor or display. Monitor is a visual output device that displays the information generated by a computer's hardware and software. It is the screen you look at to interact with your computer and see the results of your actions. Monitors come in various sizes, resolutions, and technologies. Monitor power light. It glows when your monitor is on. Monitor backside. The backside of a monitor typically has ports for various connections, such as HDMI, display port, power input. Monitor power port. The monitor's power port is where you connect the power cable to supply electrical energy to the monitor, allowing it to function. Monitor VGA port. The VGA video graphics array port on a monitor is a common analog interface used to connect computers and display devices, delivering video signals. Keyboard. It is the most important input device of a computer, can be wired or wireless. Mouse. Which is an input device, can be wired or wireless. CPU. That is central processing unit, called the brain of the computer. CPU looks like this from front side, and can have some connectors for various peripheral devices. DVD driver. Is used to read or write information from a DVD. CPU power light. It glows when the CPU is powered on. CPU power switch on and off. You have to press this button to switch your computer on or off. CPU restart button. Is used to restart the computer system. CPU front USB. Generally there are two USB ports in front side of a CPU. CPU backside. The backside of a CPU typically has various ports and connectors for peripherals, devices and expansion cards. SMPS. That is switch mode power supply. CPU power port. A CPU power port is used to provide essential electrical power to the central processing unit CPU in a computer. PS to keyboard or mouse port. This port is not in use nowadays. You can connect your keyboard or mouse using USB port and with a Wi-Fi dongle in case of wired and wireless keyboard or mouse. USB 2.0 port. Generally there is up to 4 USB ports in backside of a CPU. Parallel port. This port was traditionally included in CPUs to facilitate the high-speed, parallel data transfer between the computer and external devices like printers and scanners, allowing for efficient and fast data printing and sharing. But today you will rarely find this port in your computer. VGA, that is video graphics adapter port. This port is connected with the monitor through a cable called VGA cable, which can be easily distinguished from other cables by its blue connector with 15 pins. This cable is also being largely replaced by HDMI cables. LAN port, that is local area network port, also known as an Ethernet port or network port, is a hardware interface on a computer or network device that allows it to connect to a local network using Ethernet cables. These ports typically have an RJ45 connector, which is the standard interface for Ethernet connections. LAN ports are used to establish wired connections to a local network, providing devices with access to shared resources, internet connectivity, and communication with other devices within the same network. They are commonly found on computers, routers, switches, and other networking equipment. Microphone port, which is pink in color, often referred to as a microphone jack or microphone input, uses 3.5 mm jack, is a hardware interface found on computers. This port is designed to connect an external microphone to the device, allowing it to capture audio input from the microphone. Line output port, which is lime green in color, a line out port, often referred to as a line out jack or audio output jack, is a hardware interface found on computers. This port is designed to transmit audio signals from the device to external audio equipment, such as speakers, headphones, amplifiers, or recording devices. Line input port, which is light blue in color, a line-in port, also known as a line-in jack or audio input jack, is a hardware interface found on computers. This port is designed to accept external audio signals, allowing the device to receive audio input from external sources, such as microphones, musical instruments, cassette players, CD players, and other audio devices. how to connect these different devices and assemble a computer system, monitor power connection, connect the monitor's power cable to a working power outlet for it to function properly. Monitor power cord. The monitor power cord is an essential component that supplies electricity to your monitor, ensuring it functions correctly. Monitor power port. The monitor power port is where you plug in the power cable to provide electrical power to the monitor. Monitor VGA connection. A VGA connection is an analog video interface commonly used to connect older monitors and computers, delivering video signals via a 15-pin VGA cable. Monitor VGA cable. You have to connect a VGA cable which can be distinguished from other cables by its blue 15-pin connector. Monitor VGA port. Plug one end of VGA cable with this 15-pin female connector. CPU VGA connection. The second end of the VGA cable is connected with the CPU side. CPU VGA cable. You have to connect the second end of the VGA cable with your CPU. CPU VGA port. Plug one end of VGA cable with this 15-pin female connector. So to connect a CPU to a VGA port, you have to simply plug one end of a VGA cable into the CPU's VGA output and the other end into the VGA input on the monitor. Keyboard connection. To make a keyboard connection, plug the keyboard's PS2, USB or wireless receiver into an available PS2, USB port on your computer. Keyboard cable. A keyboard cable connects the keyboard to a computer or other device, allowing data and commands to be transmitted for input. This cable may have a PS2 connector or a USB connector. Today you will find an USB connector or a Wi-Fi receiver for connecting your keyboard. PS2 keyboard or mouse port. To make a wired PS2 keyboard connection, insert the PS2 connector into the corresponding port on your computer, ensuring it's securely seated. USB mouse connection. To make a USB mouse connection, you have to simply plug the USB connector into an available USB port on your computer. USB mouse cable. A USB mouse cable is used to connect a computer mouse to a USB port for data transmission and power transmission. USB 2.0 ports. The number of USB ports on the back of a CPU can vary, but it typically ranges from 2 to 6 ports, depending on the motherboard and case configuration. In this example, you can see four USB ports. Speaker connection. To connect speakers to your computer, plug the speaker's audio cable into the computer's audio output port. Speaker cable. To connect speakers to a computer, you can use a compatible speaker cable with the appropriate connectors, like 3.5mm audio jacks or USB, depending on your computer's audio ports. Speaker line output, that is lime green in color. You have to plug the speaker's audio cable into this port, which is typically labeled as audio out or speaker out. Printer connection. To connect a printer to your computer, use a USB cable to plug the printer into an available USB port on your computer, and you have to follow the on-screen instructions for driver installation. Printer power cable. The printer power cable is an essential component that supplies electricity to your printer, ensuring it functions correctly. Printer power port. The printer's power port is typically located at the rear or side of the printer and is where you plug in the power cable to provide electricity to the printer. Printer connector cable. The printer connector cable is typically a USB or Ethernet cable, which provide the connection between your computer and the printer to transmit data and print commands. Printer connector port. The printer connector port, typically found on the back of the printer, is where you plug in the cable to establish a connection between the printer and your computer or network. Printer USB cable. The printer USB cable is a standard interface cable used to connect a printer to a computer or other compatible device for data transfer and printing. CPU power connection. To provide power to the CPU, connect the CPU's power cable from the power supply unit to the CPU power socket on the motherboard, typically labeled CPU PWR. CPU power cord. The CPU power cord typically connects to the power supply unit PSU of the computer, providing electrical power to the central processing unit CPU and other components. CPU power port. The CPU power port, also known as the motherboard power connector, is where the SMPS switched mode power supply connects to provide power to the computer's central processing unit CPU and other components on the motherboard. UPS connection. To connect UPS uninterruptible power supply to your computer, plug it into a power outlet and then connect your monitor power cord, CPU power cord and printer power cord to the UPS using their power cables to ensure uninterrupted power during outages. The computer is now assembled and ready to use. Now you have to switch on the power supply and press the power button of your CPU to start your computer. After pressing the power button, the booting process starts. A computing booting, that is also known as booting up, is the initial set of operations that a computer system performs when electrical power to the CPU is switched on. The process begins when a computer is turned on for the first time or is re-energized after being turned off, and ends when the computer is ready to perform its normal operations. On modern general-purpose computer, this can take 10 to 15 seconds and typically involves performing a power-on self-test that is post, locating and initializing peripheral devices and then finding, loading and starting an operating system. Booting your computer is the process of powering it on and starting the operating system. Visually, you will not need to know too much about this process. You will power on your machine and in a few minutes your computer will be ready to use. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.